Remember using formulas to calculate math problems in school, like 2 plus 2 equals 4, or 2 pizzas times $10 equals $20? Excel can use these same formulas to work with numerical data in your spreadsheets, just like a calculator. Excel uses standard operators for its math equations, like a plus sign for addition, and a minus sign for subtraction, an asterisk for multiplication, and a forward slash for division, and a caret for exponents. You're probably used to seeing equations like 5 plus 5 equals, but in Excel, the equal sign comes first. This is because the cell itself contains or is equal to the formula and its value. We'll start things off slow with a simple multiplication formula to figure out the total cost of paint for a list of remodeling projects. As you can see, I've done some research on price and the amount of paint I'm going to need. $30 times 6 gallons of paint. To create a formula, just click where you want the total to appear and begin with an equal sign. We're going to do 30 times 6 using the asterisk for multiplication. Now press Enter on your keyboard, and Excel displays the value in the cell. Another way to create formulas is to use cell references. A cell reference is when your formula contains cell addresses like F8 or F9 instead of the numbers in those cells. Let's give it a try on the total estimated budget. Rather than calculating 700 plus 550, the values in cells F8 and F9, we'll write the formula this way. F8 plus F9. That totals the numbers in F8 and F9, whether you leave the budget at 700 and 550 or change it to something else, say 800 and 650. The total recalculates automatically. That's why cell references are so convenient. They make it possible to update your worksheet without ever having to rewrite the values in your formulas. You can also use something called the point-and-click method to make cell references. This one is a great time saver. Now that I've calculated my estimated budget, why don't we find out how much is left after taking my wish list into account? That means I'll need to subtract my wish list total from my estimated budget, so I'm going to start my equation, then just click this cell to make reference to it. Now type your operator, in my case a minus sign, and click the next cell you want in your formula. Press Enter and the total appears. Editing formulas is also just a click away. Click the cell you want to edit, and then come up here to make your changes in the formula bar. If you make a mistake or change your mind, just use the cancel command and you'll avoid making any unwanted changes. You can also double-click the cell and make your changes right there. Simple formulas and cell references are easy to use. Why not give them a try and let Excel do the math?
Like what you just saw? Rate it.
Add a comment.
Subscribe to our channel.
The freedom to learn.
What you want, when you want.
Absolutely free.
GCFLearnFree.org.